Hey, good morning, guys. Johnny Sunshine here. Put my shades on. It's Wednesday, about 9:45. I gotta go do a, I don't usually do this, estimates. It's funny, I've been to two places in the last week. Usually I'm able to just go out and do the stuff, but this lady's got a shower. It's got an old Moen Chateau valve body in it. The shower, I believe, used to be a tub because it's got, we used to call them toe testers. It's got a spout down very low in the shower, but it's got like polished brass or an antique, whatever the hell that was, antique brass back in the day. But she called, she wants a new valve. I think I can just repair what she has in there and put a Moen Pro trim on it, or a Danco trim. But if she wants a new valve, I'll be more than happy to provide her with that. I like the fact that these old valve bodies have volume control. 1225 cartridge. I don't know if you get more water out of them than you do a newfangled, new water restriction valve body. But I'm gonna go over here and check it out. This woman, she's like Russian, and she's got the most sultry voice. I remember working for this lady. Her voice is just beautiful, man. It's music to my ears. And unfortunately, the rest of her doesn't match up with that voice for me. But man, let me tell you something. She's got a beautiful voice. I am only about 5 minutes away, so we'll see what we can get into today, guys. Alright, guys, so I'm at this job. I've never seen anything like this. It's very strange. This cabinet is here. Let me get a better view. It's got this shelf in the shower, a window here. The shower head is coming out of the ceiling instead of being a straight. They got it spraying that way. It does have a valve and a spout in the wall. It's a Moen 1225. And most likely this was a tub, would be my guess. I don't know. I mean, it's just odd. It's very deep shower. Definitely not a handicap shower curb. You need to have pretty strong legs to get over that. But the polished brass, it's gotta go, Joe. Hey, how you doing? So this isn't the lady I thought it was. She's gonna talk to her husband about, you know, what the issue, what they want to do. Maybe. This thing just spins, so that's not working. Something happened here that's not right. Maybe it drips, and it looks like there may be some water building in this shower. Lighting's pretty bad. Let me go get a light. Alright, guys, so I let this water run for a minute. She's holding water in the shower. The drain needs to be cleared. I guess where are we waiting for your husband, ma'am?
Yeah, he's gonna be
right
now. Alright. But like what we wanna do is basically to change all
the... Put the chrome trim on here. Put a new cartridge. And then change that up there. Do you want that same bend?
No, we want kind of, you know, like a rain.
You want a rain head?
Yeah.
Okay. Maybe able to get something because a rain head is going to get a lot of water on this countertop. So maybe we can get something up here that goes over and puts the rain head. You know what I'm saying?
The rain head is also can be like turned, yeah? It's like...
Yeah. It's up to you. I mean, I can change all that out. I'll put a new cartridge in, I'll rebuild this and put new trim, and it'll look brand new. Okay?
Yeah, so we can exchange all of them, right? All of that to put new
stuff. Yes, put new stuff on. Easy.
Yeah.
Very easy.
What is an estimate approximately how much it's gonna be?
Under $300. I mean, it's $150 just for the call, and that includes rodding this drain out.
Does it mean that you have to do something inside?
No. Everything's done from out here.
Okay. And what does it mean? Somebody told us that it should be something inside. I don't know.
What's that?
So our friend, he said that it should be something from the inside done. Some valve
of change the valve body. It doesn't need to be changed. This is a better valve. Listen, let me show you something.
Yeah.
Over here, see this?
Yeah.
This, you can control the volume. See, you tap it in, you get a little bit of water. And you turn it on all the way, you get a lot of water. The new valves, you can't use volume control. You know what I mean? It's either on or off. Unless you go to a more expensive valve. So I really don't think you need to change this. This is better because you get more water out of it, especially with a rain head. You need a lot of water, you know? Sir?
Hey.
How are you, my friend?
Good, how are you?
You're a bad bear?
Today, yeah.
Nice. Okay, I'm afraid now. Anyways, so let me just explain to you what I'm going to do here. But right now you got water in this shower. The drain needs to be cleaned,
mm-hmm.
Correct? Over here, I can put chrome trim, a new cartridge, new spout, and a new shower arm up there, all new chrome, for about $300.
Okay.
All right?
Mm-hmm.
Is that what you want?
So if for $300, you're going to open the drain?
Yeah.
And you're going to change everything?
Just the trim, and it might be $325 because the cartridge is $30. My normal charge is $150 for the first hour, so it's about $325.
And we're gonna have new pieces, right?
Yes.
And
I got everything on my truck, man. I can do it for you right now.
We just wanted to buy the
shower heads, but do you want to do that?
And everything's gonna work perfectly, right? We're not gonna have any issues and stuff.
I guarantee it, man.
Okay, let's do it. Let's buy a shower head.
Yeah, you get your shower head. I'll put the new one on, the new shower head, because that comes with the package. But then you can
have to go around on the behind.
No.
The
I recommend keeping this valve body. I was showing your wife that you see how you can control the volume by pushing this in and out?
Yeah.
The new valves, it's either on or off. There's no volume control. All right?
If you buy one with a volume control.
You can, but now it's an $800 job. You know what I mean? Buying...
What color is it? Gold color now. You don't.
Oh, it's polished brass, man. That stuff's played out.
Are you going to change the...
All of this.
The piece.
Everything, yes. Everything, man.
Okay, so last question. So I have said, why somebody else would actually recommend you to remove it?
Because they want you to spend more money.
I don't know. Okay, I guess.
Okay, let's do it then. We'll let you know.
This old valve body will last for 100 years. What's in the wall? It gives you bigger holes to get water out of. In the 80s, they decrease the size of the holes,
mm-hmm.
So you get less water.
Okay.
Let me get it done, man. I'll do it for you.
Okay, we gotta buy it, so we'll let you know, right? That's how we're gonna do it? When do you think you can buy it?
You want me to do it now, or do you want me to come back?
We don't have the shower.
We need to order it.
So what? You don't need the shower. I can do everything else but the shower. You put the shower head on.
I just want everything to change. I mean,
I got everything. I have everything.
You have those pieces?
I have all of that on my truck right now.
But you don't want no shower head?
Yeah. I mean, I'll put a shower head on it, but then you can go buy the rain head.
I'm gonna go change myself?
Yeah, or yeah, it's easy.
So I have some rain head because I ordered it, but you told me.
Oh, we have one, I think.
We decided we're gonna go ahead and change this. Just change the trim out. Put a new cartridge in. Yes, sir.
Do you accept Zelle?
Yes, I do. This was definitely a tub at one point. Spout out. Most likely it's got a nipple in here. Actually it doesn't. It's actually a slip fit. Yeah. got to really make sure that these grooves here, there's a real deep gouge there. I just need to make sure that this spout's not leaking when I put it in. So I'm gonna put a new blade in here. One of my favorite tools, this. Style mullet, two screws on the bottom trim. Slip fit tuck spout. Easy as can be. I can't believe guys actually prefer to have an adapter. What I do is I pull this thing out, tighten it up as much as so I can still turn it, get this in a position so that when I push it up against the wall, get it straight, I can just tighten it up. Turn the water off, get this cartridge out. Alright guys, I got the water off. Things have been tough lately, man. Thank you. like I said, on these guys, I try to I try to pull them straight out so that I don't get into an issue with those gaskets coming off, because this is a plastic stem. And hopefully this guy's gonna come right out. Seems like it's kind of loose, so. Here we go, nice. So one thing I always do when I yank these cartridges out is I look at the old cartridge to make sure that I've got all the pieces, all the O-rings, everything. So I know there's nothing stuck in there just by the condition of this cartridge. What I'm gonna do is hit this with some WD. Run this 3/4 inch cleaning brush in there. Mowing 1225 feet. Sorry about the noise, guys, but it's 100 degrees in this bathroom. They said the air conditioning's not working anymore. So. On these stems, see this little notch? There's a little notch right there. Providing the water pipes in the wall are correct, the notch needs to be up. They come from the factory like this, so just make sure the notch is up. If you put it in and it's wrong, just spin the cartridge, the stem 180 degrees. And I found hammering that thing in really does help, man. So I want to get some grease on this thing, just because it was very hard. No, actually, it wasn't very hard to get out. I want to make sure it's easy to get out next time, so. That's it. So I got a new stop tube there. Thank you. Yeah. And I think this is gonna need an extension kit, man. See how far these screws come out. Nah, they should work. Very deep in the wall, and there was an extension on the old one, but I'm hoping I don't have to get into all of that. See, as I tighten this down, the spout's coming out. So when I was doing new houses, I always put the spout on last, just because of that situation. Okay. So this guy was in there. I'm gonna see if it'll work without it. Spray this guy with some called an index button. Washer on that handle, and it's critical. So this has to come off. That handle will definitely split if you don't put the washer on. See these little shoulders here? This washer needs to be on there. And that prevents the plastic handle from riding up over those shoulders and splitting. So it's critical that it goes on. Tighten it up without worrying about splitting the handle. everybody. So now, guys, I have to go upstairs and get this head off. Guys, this is called a head, arm, and flange. Head, arm, and flange. I'm gonna leave the flow restrictor in because I'm coming back to replace this faucet in here for them. And and then put a rain head on for them. I've seen guys do this, and I never did that, but what the hell, man, I'm always open to a new idea. If it works, I'll put a little spooge on that there, where it goes up into the ceiling. Wondered why they made these blue. Took me like 32 years to figure out that's a wrapper. That's a joke, guys. Speaking of wrappers, they caught the guy who killed Tupac. So good. That's something. Isn't that special? So on this one, because it is hanging from the ceiling, I want to just make sure I bend a couple of these guys in, just so that it stays where I put it. I'm gonna go around one more time. I hope I don't regret it. Go turn the water back on. Hey guys, if you got one of these tools, these razor knives, just make sure you always take the blade out before you put it back in the toolbox. I'm gonna see now. I can't get any more out of this spout up against the wall. I'm just gonna dab it in real good. I've got the water on, so I'm gonna get this guy fired up. Oh. what I'm looking for is hot. Oh, I need an extension tube on this handle. That's why it keeps spinning. I have to bring one. Yeah, I'm gonna get an extension stop tube. Get the hot water over here. This thing's already filling up in there. Alright, that's getting hot. That's getting hotter. So what that's telling me is the water pipes are crossed. That's why I always wait to put the handle on, but down here, these boys, they were drunk when they were doing these houses, man. I'm telling you. It's a joke, man. It ain't that funny. So what I need to do is flip this cartridge 180 degrees, basically. Care of the issue. I gotta go see if I have an extension tube on that truck, on my truck for this. They've been living without one for years. They probably don't even know it's not right. Alright, so that's hot. Not just warm. Alright, so let me get this stop going here. Yeah.
There's definitely something down there.
out here yesterday, 2 minutes on. Definitely something in the drain. It's draining, but... This used to be a shower. So that looks like a drain right there. And that's why it's backing up. And that's why I'm having a hard time. So most likely what we have is this drain was offset from the P-trap that's over here under this wall for a tub. So there's most likely 90s here, which I'll get through it. I may have to go to a smaller machine, but we'll see. I may have to go to a smaller cable. This thing stopped up pretty damn good. Something really funky there to get this drain hooked up. Teetering on. Damaging my cable. Draining like a champ, boy. She's draining like a champ. Put a little couple of bends in my cable I didn't want to do. These things aren't cheap. Thank you. Things playing in on the shower now. Guys, I always leave the bottom of this spout open in case for some reason it leaks, but also so you can get your tool in there without an issue. Get your Allen wrench in there to clean it, take it off if they want to change it or if it needs to be changed. Thank you. I always try to get these little traces of the DAT off the chrome. I mean, it's not an issue, they'll come off eventually, but why not leave it like it's brand new? Because it is. That's it, guys. We're all set, man. Now I just need to, fix this. She's got a real slow drain here. I'm gonna take this PO apart, see if it's in this. If not, well, I'm not gonna do that because they're gonna go get a faucet and I'm just gonna fix it when I get here. It's most likely in the pop-up. All right, guys, so I'm gonna try to see what's in this. Yeah, just what I thought. Fucking nastiness.
Nastiness, yeah. Why would you wear gloves? I don't know why you would wear gloves if you could just wear one glove.
And then white. Everything in the houses was white. And they always got damaged. So you always had to go fucking replace something before the house got out of warranty. Man, just make sure you get every little bit out of there. See, I left that on there. Just rip it off. But you want to make sure you clean it really, really good. And I buy the big grout sponges and cut them in half. Because it's really, I don't need that big ass sponge to do what I got to do. Snot running down my nose. That's all she wrote, boys. These guys are in a lot better shape than they were when I got here. That's all I can tell you. Let me get these guys in here.
Hey.
Hey, man. So you're all set. I cleared this drain for you. I cleared this drain. So you're not standing in water when you take a shower. You got a new shower head temporary. We'll put a new one in. I put a new cartridge in there too. Okay? It's just easy with that valve.
The water?
Because I just coughed everything, so you gotta.
Why isn't it working?
It is, it's draining, because you got pipes going overhead. Listen, you got water pipes going over here, up the wall, and then over here and down. That's why it's brick. Okay? See, this goes automatically and drains it. When it breaks the vacuum, this pipe drains. You get a little bit of water, but that's it.
Cool.
All right, looks good, thank you. Anything else that you want to say?
So,
you get the
next time we buy this and that.
We're gonna buy two pieces. He's gonna come in as he promised and install it for us.
Yeah. All right, my friend. Let me get my stuff out of here.
Can I be ready?
You said you can do Zell?
Yeah, we can do Zell.
It's gonna be $325, man.
You gotta give me
something, right? I'll give you my business card.
Do you have
your phone number?
Is
this all right?
Yeah. These people don't trust me as far as they control me. I can tell you don't trust me too much.
Why would I trust you? I met today.
What do you mean? You can't trust me because you met me today?
Why would you trust blind to somebody?
So I trust people immediately. I can sense if they're a thief or if they're somebody I don't want to do business with.
That's a good trait.
I can read people real fast.
That's a good job. I'm not saying it's a bad job.
So wait, this is you, yeah? 941-944.
Yes, ma'am.
How many people burned us in this construction business in Sarasota?
Well, you finally met somebody who's not going to burn you. I've been in business for 26 years. I've been doing this for 36 years. No, I don't. I'm just doing
straight. The chart says remodeling.
Yeah, I know, but that was back in the day. I used to build 250 houses a year, but I ended up with leukemia.
Oh.
And I had to have a bone marrow transplant. Can you grab that for me, my friend? Excuse me.
It says bone marrow.
What's that?
It says that it's sand. Can you just double check that?
Yeah, I'll check my phone. You can just leave it there, buddy. Hey, do you know how to shut your water off here? These people don't trust me as far as they can fucking throw me.
Just leaving it here.
Yeah, hey, do you know how to shut your water off in the event of an emergency?
No.
No?
So if you
I wanna show you. Over here, my friend. Really not my friend, but he must be one of them Russian Crimeans. That box right there, the concrete box in the ground, that's your water meter. This right here is your main shutoff. If you have an emergency, Shut that and open that.
Okay.
When you turn it back on, slowly. Let the pressure build. And then open it all the way. Okay?
Yep, sounds good.
All right, my friend. You're welcome. Let me give you. You just call me, I'll come over. Let me give you a couple business cards. Fucking dumb people. There you go, ma'am. Thank you very
much.
Have a great day,
yeah,
huh?
You too.
Bye-bye. Hey, let me check the, make sure that payment went through.
Talking about trust.
What trust?
Yeah.
The guy, let me check if the payment went through.
Just, I don't want to have to come back. I know where you guys live.
You don't trust us, all right.
Yeah. I know where you live, man. Thank you guys.
All right.
Nice meeting you. Hopefully next time you see me, you'll trust me a little bit more. Have a great day. Guys, that's gonna do it. Some love is hard earned, man. Anyways, Russian Crimea. Yeah, that's what I think. So long, and if you feel like I feel, baby, come on, oh, come on, let's get it on, oh, baby, let's get it on. That is a classic. Hopefully they won't copyright me for that 2 seconds, man. Damn. Marvin Gaye was the shit. Came from a crazy ass family. Shot by his dad back in the early 80s, man. That a bitch. That old man said, I brought you into this world, I could take you out, sucker. Fuck. That ain't good. That ain't nice.